Namaste everyone, we are the Group 5 presenter and we will be discussing the credit application and other requirements. So, credit application is the first activity in a credit department. So ito yung mga unang hakbang when you are applying for a credit in a credit department para sa business na gagawin mo or ibibigay mo. It can be orally or in a written, but since we are advanced and more in technology, we are applying sa mga internet na lang. We use our phones, laptops in applying or filling the credit application sa mga site na sa mga site nila, and mas napapadali yung trabaho natin kasi hindi na natin kailangan pumunta sa mga site nila para mag-fill lang sa mga papers. And mas helpful to ngayon since we are in a pandemic and hindi natin kailangan lumabas na ng bahay para lang mag-apply sa mga credit department. So this will be a helpful that we are in the technological advance kasi hindi na natin kailangan makapaghalubilo sa labas or hindi na natin kailangan lumabas when we are applying the credit application. So, credit application is simple as a form or used by a borrower potentially to get an approval to get approval in a credit to any credit department. So, credit application is a form lang or a form that contains initial information about us, and this information will help to the credit department if they're going to approve what we are requesting for. So yun yung meaning ng credit application. This is essential because correct filled credit applications provides the credit department. So number one is initial credit information. So sa initial credit information, tumatala ka lang dito if the credit departments or the one of the staff of credit department that are responsible for interviewing the customer is kapag tinanong kanya sa mga credit background mo or about sa information about sa'yo, kailangan mo lang maging honest and sabihin yung mga dapat na sabihin that related to their questions para hindi na nila kailangan ng credit investigations na i-apply sa'yo. So, yun lang yung sa may initial credit information. Number 2 is information. So, sa information, nakapaloob na dito yung mga core information about sa'yo or yung mga bagay na personally na ginagawa mo or na meron ka that related sa pag-fill up mo ng application. Kadalasan yung mga tanong is paano mo mababayaran yung utang na ibibigay nila sa'yo or ano yung trabaho mo. So, dun nakapasok yung information. So, number 3 is leads. So, sa leads, dito na tumutukoy yung or pumapasok yung mga information na sinabi mo sa mga past na interviews. So, if you convince the credit department sa mga information and okay ka sa kanila, mas madali silang makakapag-decisions na i-approve yung nire-request mo or yung credit na kailangan mo. So, kailangan yung mga information na sinabi mo is totoo para sa number 3 or this sa leads, mas mapadali na lang decisions na kailangan nila na makapag-decide sila na i-approve ka agad kasi yung mga information na sinabi mo is totoo and legit. Wala kang hindi sinabing fake or hindi ka nagsabi ng mga bagay na maitatago mo yung sarili mo just because para iiwas yung sarili mo sa mga bagay and hindi nila ma-disapprove yung nire-request mo. So, yun yung tumutukoy sa number 3 na leads. So, sa other requirements is step-by-step procedures and a guide. So, after ng credit department na ma-approve yung credit or loans na nire-request mo, next naman is yung papeles or mga requirements na kailangan mong ipass o i-comply in order for them na maibigay na yung credit na kailangan mo. Yung mga papeles din nito is magsisilbing guide for you para sa business na i-build mo. So, ayun yung sa other requirements.
Discuss natin dito kung ano-ano yung mga requirements na kailangan ng isang enterprise para ma-accomplish yung kanyang loan application. Una na dito ay ang individual or single proprietorship o mas kilala sa tawag na sole proprietorship. Bago natin alamin kung ano-ano yung mga requirements na kailangan ng single proprietorship, alamin muna natin kung ano ito. Ang sole proprietorship ay isang uri ng enterprise na kung saan ito ay pagmamay-ari ng isang tao lamang. Pero hindi ito nangangahulugan na siya lang mag-isang nagtatrabaho. Maaari siyang kumuha ng mga empleyado na kung saan tutulong sa kanya para magpatakbo ng kanyang business. Unang requirement na kailangan ng isang single proprietorship para ma-accomplish yung kanyang loan application ay a certified photocopy of its trade name or style registered with the Bureau of Domestic Trade. Kailangan may katunayan na yung trade name or style ng business mo is naka-registered sa Domestic of Trade and Industry or DTI. Sunod, kailangan meron kang mayor's permit, katunayan na ikaw ay binibigyan permiso na magpatayo ng business within the city. Pangatlo, license to engage in business issued by the city or municipality. Kailangan registered yung business mo sa LGU para katunayan na na-approve yung business mo within the city or municipality. Pang-apat, kailangan yung income tax return mo is may katunayan ka na nakapagbayad ka and kailangan meron kang official receipt of payment na galing sa BIR. And lastly, latest audited and unaudited financial statement. Kailangan meron kang annual report per year para sa audited and kailangan nakapag-report yung company mo during the whole year para naman sa unaudited financial statement. Pangalawa, para sa partnership naman, ang partnership ay isang uri ng enterprise na kung saan ito ay pagmamay-ari ng dalawang tao, kung saan meron silang kasunduan na sila ay magtutulungan upang patakbuhin ang business. Sila rin ay may kasunduan na maghahati sila sa puhunan, kita, or kahit sa mga liabilities. Ang unang kailangan or requirement na isang partnership is kagaya sa sole proprietorship, kailangan rin na registered yung trade name or style ng business nila sa DTI. Pangalawa, kailangan meron silang copy ng articles o kasunduan nila bilang isang magpartner at kailangan registered ito sa Securities and Exchange Commission. Pangatlo, kailangan kagaya sa sole proprietorship, kailangan meron din silang latest audited and unaudited financial statement of the partnership. Yun nga, kagaya na sinabi ko kanina, na ang audited, kailangan meron silang annual report per year. At sa unaudited naman, kailangan nakapag-report yung company nila during the whole year para sa unaudited, para sa financial statement nila. And pang-apat, income tax return for preceding year of each member of partnership. Kailangan rin bawat member sa kanila or bawat isa sa kanila is nakapagbayad ng income tax return nila sa BIR. Sunod, license to engage in business issued by the city or municipality. Dito rin kailangan nakaregistered sila or may lisensya sila galing sa LGU na katunayang na-approve yung business nila within the city or municipality. Sunod, kailangan meron kayong resolution of the partnership authorizing the negotiation of the loan. Kailangan meron kayong agreement na kayo ay magtutulungan at i-authorize nito ang negotiation of the loan. And lastly, kailangan parehas kayong may curriculum vitae kung saan nakasaad dito kung ano-ano yung mga karanasan or personal life experiences nyo about sa work.
How to form a coalition for real estate transactions. Buying and selling real estate in a corporation gives you limited liability against lawsuit. So sa pagbili daw po at pagbibenta ng corporation, limitado lang po yung liability na may lalabas. Lalo na pag against po yung batas. This makes the corporation responsible for paying any judgments or settlements. So, pag dito po, mahalo po may utang po, responsibilidad po na magbayad agad lalo na pag may kasunduan kayo ng pinagmahal. In addition, your personal property cannot be seized by the court or a creditor. So, yun po, pag warning, sarili po kayong income or savings, hindi po ito pwedeng galagyan ng sumisingal at ng korte. Most states have similar procedures for incorporating a real estate business. So, lahat daw po ng real estate ay para sa mga prosedyo na sinusunod. Hindi po sila makakaiba. So, like an entity, a limited liability company, S corporation or C corporation are provided with limited liability protection. LLC have fewer reporting and regulatory requirements than C corporation. So, sa C corporation is marami pong limitadong bagay na gagawin nila para kumaprotekta ng isang then sa LLCs po unti lang po yung mga reportings po nila yung regulation na sumusunod at mga requirements na kailangan kesa sa C corporations. Both LLC and S corporations are true entities passing copies and resources directly to the owners instead of retaining them at the corporate level. So, LLCs and S corporations ay para sa mga pinapasong copies tapos yung mga accounts na ginagamit ko nila sa mga may-ari. Imbis na yung sa corporate level. You must choose a name for your real estate corporation that conforms to your state's requirements. So, mahalaga rin po na pumili ko yung pangalan ng corporation para po kasama rin po kasi sa requirements. Holding the real estate. Once your company is incorporated or real estate transactions are conducted in the corporation's name. So, ang isang company po ay lahat ay incorporated. Kailangan po yung transactions sila is pasado or para parehas. Lalo na nakasarang araw yung pangalan. When you purchase real estate, the deed lists the corporation as the owner. All real estate bills such as mortgage, insurance, policies, and utilities are paid by the corporation and not by you personally. So lahat po ng bills ng mortgage, na insurance, and other utilities, mas bayad po ng corporation. Hindi po pwede magbayad, bayaran ng sarili mo. Selecting the entity for a real estate purchase proposal. In the first part of our series, concerning entity selection for owning real estate, we address sole proprietorships and tenants in common. In part 2, we address the business and tax law considerations of partnerships. So, dito naman po sa first part na pag sa-select po ng entity ng real estate is kailangan naka-address din po sa isang solo business. Kumbaga po sa sari-sari store, ganyan po. Tapos yung sa parte naman, i-address na lang po siya ng address po yung business sa tax law and may consideration po siya ng partnerships.
Good day everyone, I'm Sarah Emma Humot from FMGT2C and for today, I will discuss to you about untitled real estate and about properties under administration. So before we start, what do we mean about untitled real estate? It is untitled land and unregistered land that is sold prior to council registration and is typically of new estate or new land releases. For you to understand more, untitled real estate is yung mga lands or properties na hindi pa rehistrado. So, the following that I will discuss is the requirements of buying a untitled real estate. Number one is tax declaration. What is tax declaration about? It is a property record which is traditionally assessment document. So, sino nga ba yung mga nagme-maintain ng tax declaration? Sila yung mga provincial, city, or municipal assessors, showing among others the market and assessed values of the property as the basis for the collection or real property tax. Number 2, affidavit. Ito yung kasulatan o kasunduan, basically in a form of legal agreement, that is written in a formal paper. In this affidavit, dapat nakasaad dito na yung applicant is willing to occupy openly, peacefully, and especially continuously and adversely against the woolward for at least 5 years. For the property, he offer as a security. To sum up the idea in affidavit, the applicant must be valuable and accountable to his or her obligation based on the contract. Then, number 3 is real tax receipt. For the last 5 years again, property tax is the annual amount paid by a land owner to the local government or the municipality corporation of his area. Example, in India, the municipal corporation of a particular area assesses and imposes the property tax annually or semi-annually. The tax amount is based on the area, construction, property size, and so on. So, dito yung real tax receipt. Dapat ma-assure na fully paid ito, dapat may assurance na ma-fully paid nung customer. Then, this receipt is must given by the treasurer of the current place where offered collateral. It must be 5 years fully paid. Then, yung 4 is certification from the clerk of court of the place where offered collateral. Ito yung certification naman na to. Dito, i-assure na yung in-offer na collateral ay hindi ginamit na litigation or kung anong land registration proceeding. Then, number 5 is affidavit of two adjacent lot owner. This affidavit is for confirming na yung applicant will continue to possess doon sa lot for at least 5 years. Then, yung number 6 is certification from the Bureau of Lands para malaman o mapatunayan na yung land na inoffer as a security ay hindi part ng kung anong public domain naman. Having this certification proves that this land is authenticated or validated. Then, number 7 is survey or location plan of lot. Itong requirements naman na to, dapat may names of street and distance from the same to the nearest intersection. Ito yung distance dun sa katabing lot or land. And yung mga halimbawa nun is yung church or building and iba pa. Then yung lastly, number 8 is photograph of improvement, if any, kung meron man. Those photo will serve as an eye to those willing to buy those properties or untitled land. It serves as a good advantage para dun sa mga willing na bumili ng properties or land. Kasi dun nila malalaman na quality yung gusto nilang mabili. Property under administration means that current property that is a court order has been made the debtor's estate will be placed under administration. It only means that an administrator is appointed who will ensure the debtor pays the amount due in terms of a judgment or other financial obligation. Ito yung property na under administration. Ito yung mga property na may kaakibat na credit. Yung unang requirements is letter of administration. So, ayun yung makikita sa PPT. It means that it is a formal paper that contains message from administrator. Then, yung second one is court order. Ito yung requirement na may authorized dapat ng guardian para may pautang yung property ng kung sinong minor pa lang. Then, para din makapag-sign na ng promissory note, then mortgage contract and credit agreement and iba pang relative legal document. So, ito yung dalawang requirement para makapag-avail or magkaroon ng ability for property under administration. So, that is all about my report. Thank you.
Rise as well. So, under chattels, we can see that an itemized list certified by the borrower showing the following. First is within the machineries and equipment. An itemized list certified by the borrower showing the following of the number of units of the machineries and equipment, the location of machineries and equipment, brief description of machineries, receipts or other evidences of ownership, such as deeds of sales. Next one is the office furniture and equipment. An itemized list certified by the borrower showing the following of the number of units of the office furniture and equipment, the location of the office furniture and equipment, brief description of the equipment, the serial number, if there's any, in the furniture and the equipment, then the other evidences of ownership such as deeds of sales. Then when it comes in motorcycle vehicle, an itemized list certified by the borrower should have the following. The LTO registration or the certificate of registration, the official receipt of the payment or the OR. In the last slide, we can see the example of LTO registration and the official receipt payment of the motorcycle vehicle. So let's proceed with the merchandise inventory. Merchandise inventory reflects the total amount paid for the products that are yet to be sold. Under of it, an itemized list certified by the borrower showing the following: the description of the merchandise or the product, the number of units of the merchandise or the product, and the price of each item. So in here, in this slide, we can see the LTO, new registration certificate, and in the other side or the right side, you can see the official receipt of the LTO office. The next is, it is the example of affidavit of ownership or affidavit of control. In this affidavit of ownership, we can see that is the stated name of the owner of the machineries, equipment, or the other furnitures, and the number that he has, or the number of the equipment of the machineries and the furniture that he has owned.
Pledge and share of stocks. The definition of a pledge is something held as security on a contract, a promise, or a person who is in trial period before joining an organization. So, for example, of a pledge is a cash down payment on a car. Stock certificate. A stock certificate is a physical piece of paper that represents a shareholder's ownership in a company. Stock certificates include information such as the number of shares owned, the date of purchase, an identification number, and usually a corporate seal and signatures. A stock certificate, this certificate is usually issued as written evidence of ownership to one who buys the shares of stocks. Financial statement. So financial statements are written records that convey the business activities and the financial performance of a company. Financial statements are usually often audited by government agencies, accountants, firms, etc. to ensure accuracy and for tax financing or investing purposes. Financial statements also include balance sheet, income statement, and cash flow statement. Deposit. Cash deposits are money put into a bank account via electronic transfer, ATM, or bank teller. They can be in the form of cash, checks, or money transfers and may come from places other than typical income sources like a payback, tax refund, retirement account, social security trust, and stocks, bonds, and mutual funds. Savings account. A savings account is an interest-bearing deposit account held at a bank or other financial institution. Through these accounts, typically pay a modest interest rate, their safety and reliability make them a great option for parking cash we want available for short-term needs. Savings accounts have some limitations on how often you can withdraw funds, but generally offer exceptional flexibility that's ideal for building an emergency fund, saving for a short-term goal like buying a car or going on vacation, or simply sweeping surplus cash you don't need in your checking account so it can earn more interest elsewhere. Letter of a credit. A letter of credit or credit letter is a letter from a bank guaranteeing that a buyer's payment to a reseller will be received on time and for the correct amount. In the event that the buyer is unable to make a payment on the purchase, the bank will be required to cover the full of remaining amount of the purchase. It may be offered as a facility. Secretary is a person who has signed a document such as a treaty or contract or an organization, state, and any other more, on whose behalf such a document has been signed. Income tax return. So the income tax return or the ITR is a form which a person is supposed to submit to the income tax department of the province. It contains information about the person's income and the taxes to be paid on it during the year. Income from salary, profits and gains from business and profession, income from house property.